In this video, we will talk about a very important concept, which we will need in test-driven development now and then, which is called as mock testing. Okay. Now, in order to understand what exactly is mock testing, you can see that I have a very simple project here. This project is basically nothing but it's a simple customer library, a customer class. And if you go here, you can see that this customer class has a very simple function called as addCustomer. Okay. And this add customer actually goes and inserts records into SQL server. Okay, for now let's assume that there is some code in area.net here which actually goes and inserts records into SQL server. Okay, now before this add customer actually goes and inserts records into SQL server, it actually goes and sends an email saying that somebody has inserted a record into SQL server. Okay, so for that we have a very simple component we have created called as the email component. Okay. So in the same project, you can see that I have created a library called as my email library. And in this my email library, you can see that there is a simple class here called as my email, and it has a function called as send email. Now this send email function is very straightforward. You can see over here, it actually goes and sends an email to questpond@questpond.com, which is email where we would like to get notifications when a new customer is inserted. So what it does is it actually goes and connects to the SMTP server. It goes and adds the from and the to address. It adds a subject, saying that the customer has been inserted, and then it does a send email. Okay. Now this is all well and good. So this function, so this program, this project compiles successfully. So this project, my email library, is currently used inside the addCustomer. Okay. And we have written a very simple test case here which actually goes and tests this customer project. So you can see that it goes and creates a object of the customer class, and it calls the add customer function, and if the add customer function returns true, then this test case passes. Okay. Now if I go and try to run this test case, I have a problem. Okay. So if I try to go and run this test case, let me go and do a run selection here, and the problem is this error over here. You can see that it has thrown up exception, and if you go and see this error very closely, you can see that this error says that there is an issue while we are trying to send the email, and that is right. Why? Because we are still doing testing, we are still in the development phase, and the SMTP or the email server is yet not configured, so definitely this code will fail. Now we are fine with that, because we understand that the SMTP will be live only when we actually go onto the live server, and currently because we are in the development environment, so this code of send email will definitely crash, and that's fine. But because of this, we are getting into other problems of testing. Now because this email code is crashing here, due to the inavailability of the SMTP server, I'm not able to go and test if my ADO.NET code is working or not. So what I would like to do is that I would like to say, okay, is it possible to go and bypass this code of email for now and just go and test my add customer code, right? So in other words, what I would like to do is I would like to do modular testing. Okay, so I would like to say, okay, I understand that the email component will not work, but I would like to still go and test my add customer for the remaining part of the code. So in other words, what we would like to do is we would like to go and bypass this code here of the send email thing what we have here, and then basically just go and try to test this part of the code where we have area.net. So how do we do it? And just in case, if you are thinking about some weird idea like how about going and commenting this code and then going and doing the testing, definitely that is not the right thing. So in other words, what we are saying is that go and adjust our code as per the test cases, which we don't want. We want that the development guy should just go and do his development, and the tester guy should actually go and test the code. Okay, so there is no way that we would like to go and change our code because our test case is not working, right? So that's not what we would like to do here. Always remember that the test case is written because we want good code. It is not that we write code because we want to run a test case, right? So definitely that those kind of weird ideas, in case you are having, just leave it. Okay, so how do we go and now bypass this code? And that's by using something called as mock testing. Now by using mock testing, what we can do is we can say that this send email function should always return true. Okay, in other words, it should just go and return everything successfully, and should not actually go and run this part of the code. Okay, So in other words, you know, we would like to go and mock this code out. In other words, we would like to go and just say that don't run, you know, the send email function code. Okay. Now, in order to do mock testing, you know, there are lots of open source what you call tools around there, like Rhino mocks and then MOQ mock and lots of other tools, right? For this project, you know, we're going to use the MOQ mock testing framework. Okay, so let's go to a solution explorer and let's go and add the mock component to our test customer here. So let me click on add references here and reference the mock DLL. Now, where do we get this mock DLL from? In order to get the mock DLL, you can go and go to this link here, code.google.com/p/mock. And over here, you can go to downloads and you can go and download the mock libraries or the mock binaries. Okay. Once you have downloaded the mock binaries, you know, you should be able to go and unzip them in a separate folder here. And for now, because we're going to go and rest, because currently my project is .NET 4.0, I'm using the .NET 4.0 DLL here. So I will go and reference this DLL in my test project here. So I'm going to say okay. And you can see that the mock DLL is now referenced inside my test project. Now let me just go and delete this code here, because we're going to use mock. The first step is we have to go and import the mock namespace in our test project, right? Now, using a mock is a two-step process. At least, you know, basically there are two steps. You know, there are some other other steps also. You know, in case you are doing advanced testing in advanced testing using mock. Okay, but basically, you know, at least for, you know, even if you want to do a very simple project or a simple test, you will at least need two things from mock. So one is that basically you're going to go and create the object. So that's one step. The second is you're going to go and set up, you know, saying that, you know, which method should return what, or I'll say you need to go and specify which functions you want to bypass, right? So the first thing is you'll say mock. So what do you want to mock? I want to mock that email component, my email, because it has some code, you know, which cannot run in this scenario or in this condition. Okay, I'm going to say obj email is equal to new email, right? My email. Now after that, you know, once that is done, then you will say okay, now you'd like to go and set up the mock. So I'm going to say here obj email dot setup. So how do you want to set up? I want to ensure that my send email, okay, returns true. Send email will return true. Now this statement is very important. You know, what we are saying is that this object, or you know, this email component is mocked, and from that, you know, whenever anyone calls a send email function, it will always return true. You know, in other words, you know, irrespective of the code passes or the code crashes, he will return true. Okay, now let's go and create the object of customer class. We're going to say obj is equal to new customer, right? And let's go ahead and call the add function. So we're going to say obj.addCustomer, and we'll send this mocked email component which we have just created. Okay, and we will say here boolean is inserted. Okay, and obj.customer, why is this failing here? Okay, this is obj.email.object. Okay, so it's not this obj email object which we have created is of the type mock. So we have to say obj email dot object, so that object is actually the email object. Okay, and now we'll do assert saying that this test case will pass if this customer or, you know, this is inserted is true, right? So what we have done now, so the first step, we have gone ahead and we have created an email object, and that email object is now mocked, you know, stating that now mocked, you know, or I'll say the send email function of the email object is now mocked, saying that whenever you call the send email function, it will always return true. And this mocked component is now sent to this add customer. So now, you know, whenever this add customer actually is called, you know, he will never ever go and call the send email function. It will always return true. Okay, so let me just go and build this, and everything should pass here. Now let me go and run the test. But what I'll do is I'm going to go and run this test in a debug mode to see that how exactly the bypassing takes place. Okay, so I'm going to go and right click and say debug selection. So there the test project has invoked the add customer function. So we're going to go and do step into. So now if I do a step into, you can see that he has completely bypassed the code. You know, he has not actually stepped into this email function over here. Okay, and now I return back from here. He goes and executes this code, and this returns true, and you know, this test case passes. Okay, so in other words, you know, what has happened is, you know, we are now able to go and test our customer class here. Okay, so in other words, we are able to go and test this customer code here, and at the same time, you know, we are ensuring that you know, the code which cannot run for now is bypassed. So by using mock testing, you know, what you can do is that you can do modular testing. So modular testing means, you know, when you have two components and both of these components are using each other, and for some reason, you know, you want to go and test them separately so that, you know, you guarantee that your system is completely tested in a proper unit test fashion, then you can use mock testing, where you can go and bypass one section of the code and then go and test the other section of the code. Now, one more important point to remember here is that whichever function you want to go and mock, that function has to be virtual. Okay, so this is a very important concept to remember. Now, you know, I know that many developers can argue that, you know, my functions can be non-virtual, so, you know, how to test non-virtual functions, etc. Must be we can have a separate lecture on that, you know, where we'll talk about basically, you know, something called as loose mock testing and something called as strong type mock testing. Okay, but for now, you know, at least for the mock framework, that is MOQ framework, you need to ensure that this function is virtual. Okay, so I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we saw that how we can go and do mock testing and bypass, you know, some section of the code and then test, you know, the rest part of the code in a proper manner.